I mean, you know, we all know that everybody lives in their own private universe to a certain extent, and some people who are capable of externalizing the contents of their consciousness, you know, which is why I love cinema. So Gene Youngblood, he wrote a book called Expanded Cinema, which is basically a psychedelic account of cinema. He says cinema reflects mankind's historical drive to manifest his consciousness outside of his mind in front of his eyes. Yeah. So cinema as a mirror that we hold up to ourselves, that reveals us to ourselves, that is essentially consciousness externalized.
Yeah.
Consciousness meets its own process with cinema.
Yeah.
And that everything about how cinema works reflects how our minds work, not how reality works.
Right.
The close-up represents attention. The flashback represents memory.
Yeah.
The foreshadowing or the dreamlike future possibility shots represents our capacity to think about the future.
Let's suppose that you were able every night to dream any dream you wanted to dream. And you would naturally, as you began on this adventure of dreams, you would fulfill all your wishes. You would have every kind of pleasure. And after several nights, you would say, "Well, that was pretty great. But now let's have a surprise. Let's have a dream which isn't under control. Well, something is going to happen to me that I don't know what it's going to be." Then you would get more and more adventurous, and you would make further and further out gambles as to what you would dream. And finally, you would dream where you are now. Awaken from this illusion, and you understand that black implies white, self implies other, life implies death. You can feel yourself not as a stranger in the world, not as something here on probation, not as something that has arrived here by fluke, but you can begin to feel your own existence as absolutely fundamental. What you are basically, deep, deep down, far, far in, is simply the fabric and structure of existence itself.
Cinema reflects how consciousness works, but the fact that multiple people can relate to one singular vision, one singular movie, shows that everybody experiences consciousness the same to a certain degree.
Sure.
So even though we all live in our own private universe, there are commonalities in terms of interior experience, and our capacity to come up with symbols and frameworks to share that commonality allows for intersubjective coherence and communal ecstasis and allows us to feel not alone in our own heads, but rather part of a whole.